गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, डिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर द राइज ऑफ स्मॉल किंगडम्स इन नॉर्थ इंडिया इज गोइंग ऑन. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड विथ यू थ्री पावरफुल किंगडम्स अरोज बिटवीन 750 CE एंड 1000 CE आउट ऑफ द ड्यून्स ऑफ हर्षाज एम्पायर. एंड दीज किंगडम्स वेयर द राष्ट्रकुटाज, द पालाज एंड द प्रतिहाराज. आफ्टर दैट वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ट्राइपार्टाइट स्ट्रगल. टुडेज टॉपिक इज द राजपूत एंड द गवर्नेंस इन नॉर्थ इंडिया. लेट अस सी. अराउंड 9th century CE द होल ऑफ नॉर्थ इंडिया हैड बिकेम अ पैचवर्क ऑफ स्मॉल किंगडम्स एज द पावर ऑफ द राष्ट्रकुटाज, द पाल्स एंड द प्रतिहार्स एंडेड ऑलमोस्ट साइमल्टेनियसली. द प्रतिहार्स ऑफ सेंट्रल इंडिया, द पाल्स ऑफ बंगाल एंड द राष्ट्रकूट्स ऑफ दक्कन वॉन्टेड टू एस्टेब्लिश देयर सुप्रीमेसी ओवर कन्नौज एंड द फर्टाइल गैंगेटिक वैली. Their tripartite struggle lasted nearly 200 years and weakened all of them and enabled to overthrow them. During the 10th century CE, three important developments took place in medieval India. First, North India came in close contact with Western and Central Asia. Second, most of the kingdoms came under the rule of Rajputs who were constantly at war with one another. Finally, the continuous wars created political instability, which was the major causes of beginning of Turkish invasion in North India. The Rajput played an important role in medieval India. They were famous for their bravery, honor and prestige in Indian history. The word Rajput means son of a Raja or king, but all the Rajputs do not belong to royal families. Many Rajput families trace their origin to sun or moon and thus are known as Suryavanshi and Chandravanshi respectively. Some historians believe that the Rajputs are the descendants of foreign tribes who had settled in India. It is also believed that the main four clans of Rajputs were born from fire altars. Hence, they are also known as Agni Kulaj. They are Parmars, Malwa. Pratihars belonged from Rajasthan, Gujarat. Chauhans belonged from Ajmer and Chalukyas belonged from Gujarat. The Chahmans or Chauhans enjoy a special place of prestige among all the Rajput clan. The Chauhans king ruled over Gujarat and part of Rajasthan. Prithviraj Chauhan was the most powerful king among Chauhans. He came to the throne in 1177 CE. He made many conquests. He conquered many small states of Rajasthan and Bundelkhand. His achievements and exploits have been described by his court poet Chand Bardai in his famous book Prithviraj Raso, which narrates his bravery and heroism. In AD 1191, he defeated an Afghan ruler, Sultan. Now we will discuss governments in North India. First, we will know the administration of that period. The king was all powerful in North India. He was assisted by different officers. The empire was divided into provinces. The king was the head of military as well as judiciary. The king spent huge amount of money on building up strong armies. After that, we will know about economy. There were a great economic disparity among different social classes. The royal, high officers and the traders were prosperous. The people living in villages were poor. The temples were the center of riches and hence attracted a lot of invaders. Feudal systems. After that, we will know condition of education. Superstitions and narrow-mindedness were a great hurdle to education. The universities of Nalanda and Vikramshila became important center of higher education. The study of philosophy and religions was encouraged, but subjects like mathematics and science were ignored in that time. The regional languages developed. Pali and Prakrit languages were used for writing books on Buddhism and Jainism. Now we will know the religious condition of that time. The Rajputs mainly worshipped gods Vishnu and Shiva. They also worshipped goddesses Kali, Lakshmi and Durga. Rajput kings gave gift of land to the Brahmins, that is known as Brahmadev or Agrahara. Hinduism became more popular than Buddhism. During this period, the Bhakti saints preached devotion to God and opposed social discriminations, superstitions and narrow-mindedness. Now we will know the art and architectures of that time. The examples of paintings of North India can be found in the form of murals in palaces, caves and temples. The Jain monks and painters of Bengal developed the art of miniature paintings. The Lingraj and Mukteswar temple at Bhubaneswar and the Sun temple at Konark are the fine examples of architectures of the period from 8th to 12th century. After that, we will know the trade relation. India developed trade relations with the countries of East, Southeast, West, Central Asia and the European countries. This brought Indians into close contact with the development in other countries. The common features in the political, social and cultural life in different parts brought the people of India closer. Later on, this proved to be a great boon for Afghan, Turkish and Mughal rulers to establish their rule in India. Now we will discuss some question answer. First question is, name four main clans of Rajput. The four main clans of Rajput were Parmars from Malwa, Pratihars from Rajasthan, Gujarat, Chauhans from Ajmer, Chalukyas from Gujarat. Second question is, who was Chand Bardai? Chand Bardai was the court poet of Prithviraj Chauhan. He composed an epic poem, Prithviraj Raso, which narrates his bravery and heroism. Third question, describe the religious condition of North India during the medieval period. The religious condition of North India during the medieval period was as under. The Rajputs mainly worshipped gods Vishnu and Shiva. They also worshipped goddesses Kali, Lakshmi and Durga. Rajput king gave gift of land to the Brahmins. Hinduism became more popular than Buddhism. During this period, the Bhakti saint preached devotion of God and opposed social discrimination, superstitions and narrow-mindedness. Now, next question is, define miniature paintings. A small painting executed with great details is known as miniature painting. And last question, define mural paintings. Any piece of artwork painted or applied on a wall, ceiling, etc. is known as mural paintings. Students, like these questions, you have to find out some more questions from today's topic and write to answer. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.